Okay. What is this? Here, catalyst used and the reactants are not in the same phase. These are not in the same phase. They are present in different phases. Heterogeneous catalysis, these are present in different phases. See here some examples. 2SO2 gas plus O2 gas gives rise to 2SO3 gas, where platinum is the catalyst which is in solid state. So gas, solid. Catalyst and the reactants are not in the same phase. Okay, you know, this heterogeneous catalysis of preparation of SO3 and from that sulfuric acid is called contact process. What is the name of this reaction? Yes, contact process. Contact process is the industrial method for the preparation of sulfuric acid. Previously, in homogeneous catalysis, I wrote a reaction. What is that? 2SO2 gas plus O2 gas, NO gas gives rise to 2SO3. That is lead chamber process. What is that? Lead chamber process. See, 2SO2 gas. Previously, I wrote SO2 gas plus O2 gas equilibrium. NO gas gives rise to 2SO3 gas. It is not heterogeneous, it is homogeneous, but this process has a specific name, that is lead chamber process. What is that? Lead chamber process. You know, lead chamber process is homogeneous catalysis, contact process is heterogeneous catalysis. Very, very important object to question it is. A reaction will be given. Which of the reaction name will be given? Which of the following is a homogeneous catalysis? Lead chamber process, contact process, Haber's method, Ostwald process. In that way, some names will be given. So you have to find out. Lead chamber process is the homogeneous catalysis, whereas contact process is heterogeneous. Okay? So in this method, SO3 formed is further used for the preparation of sulfuric acid. That's why sulfuric acid has another name, that is chamber acid. What is the other name for sulfuric acid? Chamber acid. Why is it called so? Because of its preparation by this process, chamber process. Okay, so of course chamber process is homogeneous catalysis. That's why we should not discuss in this case. So, only this is the contact process. Contact process only is the heterogeneous catalysis. See some more examples for heterogeneous catalysis. You know that in Haber's method, which chemical is prepared? Yes, ammonia. Ammonia is prepared in Haber's method. You know that Haber's method of synthesis of ammonia is an example for heterogeneous catalysis. See the reaction in that N2 gas plus 3H2 gas gives rise to here iron, which is a catalyst. Molybdenum is used as promoter, of course. Molybdenum is also a solid substance. So here, what are the products? 2NH3 gas. What is its specific name? Yes, Haber's method. Haber's method. So which chemical is prepared in Haber's method? Ammonia. What are other conditions for this? Other conditions means temperature in this process, temperature maintained is 723 to 773 Kelvin. Pressure is around 200 atmospheres. In contact process, temperature range is some 673 Kelvin to 723 Kelvin. Pressure maintained is around 1 atmosphere. Okay, so this is a contact process for the synthesis of sulfuric acid. Second one, Haber's method for the synthesis of ammonia. See, third one. Here, ammonia is oxidized. Ammonia gas is oxidized to NO gas using platinum as solid. Platinum as catalyst. So, in this reaction, the products are NO gas plus H2O liquid. To balance this, take 4 moles here, then 4 NO, total 12 hydrogens, that's why 6 H2O, then total oxygens 6 plus 4, 10. So to get 10, put 5 there. So it is the reaction. It is also having a specific name. What is that? Ostwald's process. This is Ostwald's process. Ostwald's process. In Ostwald's process, which chemical is prepared? Which substance is prepared? Ostwald's process is the industrial method for the preparation of nitric acid. But here nitric acid is not there. So it is an intermediate compound in Ostwald's process. NO is first prepared. This NO in the next step converted into NO2. NO plus O2 gives H2NO2. That NO2 formed in the third step converted into nitric acid. So in that way, in the preparation of nitric acid by Ostwald's process, the first step, oxidation of ammonia, involves a catalyst. See here, gas, solid. But in case what? Reactants and catalyst are not in the same phase. So it is an example for heterogeneous catalysis. One more example. You know, hydrogenation of oils that are alkenes. CH2 double bond CH2, it is ethene, which is a gas, plus H2 gas gives rise to nickel solid. Now it is converted into ethane, CH3 single bond CH3. This compound is ethane, this compound is ethene. In this conversion, this has a specific name. What is that? Hydrogenation. This is hydrogenation, hydrogenation of alkene. It is also an example for heterogeneous. Why? It is gas, solid. So these four heterogeneous catalysis involve gaseous reactants. Next, see some examples in the liquid phase. That means with liquid reactants. For that hydrogen peroxide decomposition, H2O2 liquid, it decomposes to H2O liquid plus O2 gas. Here also a metal catalyst can be used, like a platinum solid can be used. Okay, so liquid, solid, different. So with liquid reactant, it is an example. Similarly, with a solid reactant also, 2KClO3, it's a solid. Okay, in this, MnO2 solid gives rise to 2KCl plus 3O2 gas. See, in this reaction, catalyst and reactant are in the same phase. Solid. But it is an example for heterogeneous catalysis. Why? Two solids, mixture is considered as heterogeneous. Mixture of two solids is considered as heterogeneous system. That's why even though catalyst and reactant are in the same phase, it is considered as a heterogeneous catalysis. Okay, so these are some examples for heterogeneous catalysis. Heterogeneous catalysis means the reactants and the catalyst used are in the different phases, except in solid state. If reactant and catalyst are in solid state, now that is not considered as heterogeneous catalysis. Okay, so here three industrial methods we have learnt. What are they? Haber's method of synthesis of ammonia, contact process for the synthesis of sulfuric acid, Ostwald's process for the manufacturing of nitric acid. Okay, so Ostwald's process, contact process, Haber's method, these three are heterogeneous catalysis. Okay, whereas lead chamber process for the synthesis of sulfuric acid is a homogeneous catalysis. Can you remember this? So an objective question will be asked, which of the following is homogeneous catalysis? Options are Haber's method, contact process, Ostwald's process, lead chamber process, or simply chamber process. So among the four, which is homogeneous catalysis? Yes, lead chamber process or chamber process is homogeneous catalysis. Right. Next, let's see the mechanism of these two catalysis. Mechanism of catalysis. Mechanism of catalysis. To explain the mechanism of homogeneous and heterogeneous catalysis reactions, there are two theories. First one is intermediate compound formation theory. Second one is adsorption theory. Okay. First, have a look on intermediate compound formation theory. Intermediate compound formation theory. Intermediate compound formation theory. This theory explains homogeneous catalysis. Homogeneous catalysis. As per this theory, first, one of the reactants combines with catalyst to form an intermediate. That intermediate reacts with the another reactant to give the product. So in intermediate compound formation theory, catalyst also involves in the reaction. But finally, that catalyst is regenerated. See an example for it. First, see the concept of this intermediate compound formation theory. First, what happens in this? Catalyst combines with one of the reactants to form the intermediate. Catalyst combines with the one of the reactants to give an intermediate, which combines with other reactant, which combines with the other reactant to give the product. So this is the concept of intermediate compound formation theory. So here catalyst involves in the reaction. See an example for it. Let us take a lead chamber process. In that, what happens? SO2 gas plus O2 gas gives rise to NO gas, 2SO3 gas. What is its name? Lead chamber process. In this process, see, gas, all are in the same phase. So homogeneous catalysis. So in that, see the mechanism. Mechanism from this intermediate compound formation theory. You know, first this NO gas combines with one of the reactants O2 to form an intermediate compound 2NO2 gas, which is an intermediate. Okay, which is an intermediate. This intermediate in the second step, the intermediate formed in the first step combines with another reactant. One reactant is O2. What is another reactant? SO2. So with that it combines to form, what is that? 2NO gas plus 2SO3 gas. See here, the catalyst initially used up, but in the next step it is regenerated. So I said earlier that a catalyst should not be changed chemically permanently. A catalyst is unchanged permanently. Why? Because catalyst temporarily it may involve in the reaction, but in any of the last steps it may be regenerated. So initially used up, but finally it is regenerated. So see here, first intermediate compound is formed, but finally product is formed. So in that way we can explain intermediate compound formation theory for homogeneous catalysis. So this is homogeneous catalysis. Second one, heterogeneous catalysis. Have a look on that also.